Hello, Jared. So nice to see you. Congratulations on this movie. You completely alter every aspect of yourself. But I was very intrigued about the walk. And I was wondering if you used an animal to image, to replicate.
Well, I mean, it's a great question. It's a kind of an actuary thing to look and use, animals. It's something I think they do in acting classes quite a bit. So, and there's a lot to learn there. I mean, there are a lot. I've often, had an animal in mind with a specific character, and in the script he was described as, I think, serpentine or spleen or whatever. There's a specific word that John Lee Hancock used. So he was kind of snake-like, and I thought that was pretty fascinating. And for me, it was a huge opportunity to dive in deep and to explore brand new territory, to push myself really hard, challenge myself to not just let this be a villain or a bad guy, but to really create a character that was, immersive. But the walk was something I worked on quite a bit, and I certainly had some inspiration, with the walk. But I think it said a lot about who he was, and the walk informed the way I moved the rest of my body. So it was great fun.
There's a line in the film, they say, how's the trunk space? And it's just kind of like such a brilliant line. It made me wonder, when you look at a car, how important, what's the most important feature? And what was your first car?
Well, my what my the my first car, I actually bought this old beat up car from someone in California, and then someone ran into me like 2 weeks after I bought it and destroyed it. But it was so old and big and thick, it like I wasn't hurt at all. But then I drove a truck for 20 years, which until about 4 years ago, when my brother finally gave me a car. He's like, okay, you have to stop driving that old truck. But I think the most important thing about a car is probably who's driving it, is my first thought.
The title, The Little Things, and this movie really incrementally builds on little things. What are the little things that either lift you or tear you down? Like this character is very good at manipulating little things.
It's a great question, and I think like the preparation of the character was I should say the result of the character was the culmination of so many little things, so many small choices and some bigger ones. I had different color eyes and nose and teeth and a walk and a talk and prosthetics, and it was all of those things that kind of collectively added up into the character, the experience. And for me, there were lots of small moments that I will never forget on the movie. A twinkle in Denzel Washington's eyes when I, maybe made a gesture, a response or an ad lib, some kind of a surprise that may have happened on set. That stuff was really, that this film was full of little things like that.
Personally,
Personally, I am a big fan of little things as I've gotten older. I don't know about you, but the simpler things, the little things in life to me are the most important. I don't care about the big things as much anymore. I like a sunset. I like a meditation. I like a good meal. I like quiet things. I like a good walk. That's to me like the important things in life. As I've gotten, I know I'm getting older now, because if I see like, beautiful colors or, a tree or flowers, I'm just mesmerized by that stuff.
go for a walk every night and take too many pictures of trees and plants.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
As you should. And it's nice to talk to you, get to talk to you twice in a day.
I know, it's a special treat. Thank you so much.
Well, I'll see you on the third one, I hope.
I look forward to it.
Bye-bye.